Okay, I think this is running. I'm going to do a video about my garden. And this is winter gardening in Texas. Last year was the last straw. I've been in Texas for 20 years. And it was absolutely the last straw because we still had freezing temperatures the 1st of May. And then, of course, it's 100 degrees in June. So we had about a month for a growing season here. So, you know, everything looked beautiful. And then, of course, it got hot and then things die. And the grasshoppers were just terrible. They just, depending upon if they like the taste of the vegetable, like they love green beans. So, you know, they'd come up an inch and they were just shaved down. They ate my cabbage, ate my onions, ate my cilantro, ate my green beans and eggplants and all kinds of different things. So, okay, so we're going to winter gardening here in Texas. You know, forget conventional. So what I have right here, we got my garlic growing on the left, and then we have parsnips under the plastic, radishes, beets, turnips, and carrots. This is my greenhouse that my husband just built for me a week ago. Thanks. The plans are from Texas Prepper 2. Thank you, Texas Prepper 2. Yeah, it's pretty amazing. Made out of cattle panels. It is 17 by 16. Going inside. Okay, so here's my growing beds. And my aquaponics, fish down there, plants. We just started, this is only a week old, so there's not much to it. We got green beans and cucumbers that we're going to string up, tomatoes that we're already starting to string up, potato barrels, and down here we're going to have a vertical, as soon as my seeds, you know, things are coming up already, spinach and kale and whatever. But we'll be planting those in these vertical bottle gardens. And there's some tomatoes. And I planted squash seeds behind it. Okay, cat, let's get out. Come on, kitty, kitty, kitty. Get out. Shh. Okay. So moving around here. Okra. Okra is the one thing you can grow in Texas. I will be, tonight it's supposed to get down to maybe 25. So this is the test of winter gardening already. It's November 12th, 2013. It's very early for a hard freeze. But I'll be picking in the rest of my okra and the rest of my peppers. Okay, so we have some little plants down here just starting. And I'll be covering all of these. Cabbage, broccoli, and some lettuce. And then I have more potatoes planted over here. Here's my cabbage. They really look great. And strawberries. Coming over, these are raised beds. They call them keyhole gardens. You're supposed to put your mulchy stuff in the middle basket and it feeds them. But the most important thing about these is that you make your own dirt. You layer cardboard and manure and, you know, the greens and browns and the little microbes turn it all into soil. So the soil is really great in these things. Okay, so, and here's my herb garden. I'm going to cover this up because I have still lavender, rosemary. I'm probably going to cut down my basil and freeze it. But I do have some sage and some dill and a new little basil plant growing. So we'll try to keep those going. Okay, my tomatoes were a failure. I took one tomato plant and put it in the greenhouse. But basically, the thing that I did wrong is the variety I chose. You know, they look like, oh, lush green. Well, for one thing, the grasshoppers were very hard on them. But I used a variety called Rio Grande, and they were terrible, terrible, terrible. On the package it said they were like Romas. I love Romas. You know, they're good for canning, but they taste really good. They're a good eating tomato. But these things are tough. Okay, so here's a close-up of the Rio Grandes. I'm going to pick them in too and pickle them. Okay, this was my cucumbers and Swiss chard, which they were okay. Green beans that didn't make it, but I used this dirt. This is the raised bed where you make your own dirt. That's what I've been using and digging out and using in my greenhouse. Peppers. I mean, peppers. Just. Okay, now, during the summer, I covered all of these raised beds. I planted these things in the spring, but I covered them with burlap and watered them all summer long. And so they survived the summer, and then once I took off the covers and it got cool enough, these things just started going to town. I'm going to try to cover them and save them tonight when it's cold. But I don't know if I'll succeed or not. But they sure have been fabulous. And, you know, bell peppers, it's hard to, they don't do so well in Texas. But see, now that it's cold, I'm getting a million bell peppers too. But of course, these little hot guys, they love it. The jalapenos and the serranos. So, okay, so tonight is the big test. Oh, these were my eggplant that are kind of coming back now. They were, see, that one would actually bloom. They were very delicious until the grasshoppers got them. But anyway, tonight is the big test of can we garden in the winter. So, you know, we'll be heating the greenhouse, and I'm going to cover everything that I want to save with, you know, first a blanket and then plastic and weight it all down with bricks. I ordered some of that fabric that's supposed to insulate up to 10 degrees. It's meant for gardens, but okay, more later.